follow along with Satori Graphics and make a neat and a sleek vector background in today's Illustrator tutorial. Making today's video possible is Milanote. Now, I've featured this awesome tool before on my channel, and it is an essential part of my workflow as a designer. It's great for generating and developing ideas throughout the design process, and all of your work can be shared with colleagues and clients at any time. Milanote is in fact free, so click the link in the description below to give it a try today and see how it can allow your designs to evolve and to flourish. So the first step for a vector background is to make a document, and I'm in Adobe Illustrator CC 2019, so your layout might appear different than mine as you can see on screen now. However, our design is going to be used for web-based graphics, and so the document needs to utilise an RGB colour mode and a resolution of 72 ppi. That's because the effects that we're going to create in today's video are going to work best on web-based documents. So for whatever reason, when I make a web-based document, the snap to grid setting is turned on in the top right corner, and I never use this, so let's turn it off. So if you want an entirely white screen on your document, press Command or Control K and then come into the user face preference settings right here, and then you can adjust the brightness to your personal preference. So let's go ahead and make a neat and a sleek vector background. So the background graphics all coexist over a gradient layer, and so we're going to first and foremost create a solid gradient background. And for this, I use a dark blue to a vibrant pinky red for my gradient, because I feel the graphics that we're going to make later really pop and sit neatly on top of such a gradient. You can set the angle to whatever you want, but I'm going to go with 45 degrees as of now, and then press M for the rectangle tool, and then cover the entire canvas with a rectangle. But it doesn't need to be perfectly up to the edge. So like with many of my tutorials, the gradient render looks fine on my screen, but on the actual video editing software, it probably would have banded lines. But your gradient should look fine however. But with the gradient selected, press Command or Control 2 to lock the object down in place. And we're now ready to make some sleek graphics to add to our background design. So first, I'm going to show you the Illustrator CC way, but also advise you how to do it when you're using CS. But first, it's wise to increase the around values in the Document Raster Effects menu, because this is going to help smoothen out blurs and drop shadow effects. Now press M for the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle. It is going to help you if you have the smart guides activated, and you can do that by pressing Command or Control U. After you've made the first rectangle, press V for the selection tool and then hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag perfectly below to duplicate a rectangle. Now use the smart guides to make sure it's perfect, and then adjust the length as you so wish. You essentially repeat this process to make up a shape for the splatter sleek effect object on your vector background. Also, make a couple of squares in the same way that I'm doing here, as this will later add to the effect and overall design. When ready, open up the Pathfinder window and select all of your rectangles, and then unite them together as one vector shape. So here is where the Illustrator CC part comes in handy. All you need to do is press A for the direct selection tool, and then with one click, you can round off the corners for the entire shape, like so. But if you have CS, then you're going to have to use the round corners effect located in the top drop-down menu. Now, let's carry on and really make our vector design background look awesome. So I feel that the design looks best if the graphic elements are rotated by 45 degrees. So let's go ahead and do that now. You can also add a gradient fill to the shape, and I personally like to keep the angle to 0 degrees on this gradient, but you can experiment with different angles for your gradient. For the actual colour of the gradient itself, I like to use a light blue to light pink, with a hint of vibrancy, and the colours do actually look better on screen using this RGB document. So as you can see, the gradient is not spread across the small balls and the splatter shape too, but pressing Command or Control G for the gradient tool would actually enable you to spread it across the entire design. So at this point, you can add a drop shadow, which I'll quickly show you how to do here. We do have some finishing touches to make before the end of the video, but for my drop shadow effect, I will play around with the settings whilst the preview box is checked. This might take some time to get right. You don't have to add the drop shadow now at this point, because we're going to add in more effects later. I just wanted to show you this now because we're going to use it later. Now for the final effect, before we crop the entire vector background, copy your shape with Command or Control C, and then paste a duplication right over the top with Command or Control F. So as you can see, the layers window, there are two identical shapes. Using the pen tool, carefully draw a line across the design like so, and then complete the path to make a shape. Press V to select off of the path, and then select the new shape and also the top splatter layer by holding down Shift. We're going to use a divide function in the Pathfinder window, and then remove the areas that we don't want to use, which will leave us with one shape. But remember to ungroup the selection first. Now add a gradient to this shape, and make both sides of the gradient black. But you must absolutely make sure that one side is 0% opacity. You can now use the gradient tool to adjust the direction and also come into the transparency or the opacity menu to adjust the opacity and the blend mode if you feel that works best for your design. Now we just have one last step to make for our design today, but you can keep adding shapes and shadows like this over your entire canvas. So as you can see on my design, I have two gradients for the shapes, the blue and pink one, but also an orange and pink one too. Now select everything and add the drop shadow that I showed you earlier, and the effect is going to look pretty awesome. Now if you've used shapes without perfectly round corners, either use the rect selection tool or the round corners effect. And when ready, press the Alt Option key plus Command or Control 2, and this is going to unlock all of the layers. Then press M for the Rectangle tool and draw a rectangle perfectly over the artboard. Finally select everything, right or control click and then use the clipping mask. And there you have a sleek and an awesome vector background using Adobe Illustrator. Having a digital mood board is super handy, and going into 2019, any design project that I'm going to start, I will include the use of Milanote too. Milanote is in fact free, so click the link in the description below to give it a try today and see how it can allow your designs to evolve and to flourish. Remember, if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design content, and also like and share this video on social media to help out my channel. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.